Kathy Baker, clean and sober.
It started with a dream.
Got an auto sale.
You're describing me, Mr. Sherman.
Made of crisp dollar bills.
We're gonna be rich, you hear me? Rich!
But the dream became a nightmare.
You're on a treadmill, having to make more and more money to pay for things we bought that we don't really need.
And the nightmare was a living hell.
Faith may move mountains, this stuff makes them fly.
You can't think anymore, you can't feel.
James Woods, Sean Young, The Boost. Premieres Friday, December 8th on Cinemax.
Get in the driver's seat. And drive.
Excuse me, there's really no need to go rushing off anywhere.
Sit down and relax.
Oh, boy. The thing is, it's all right here on Cinemax in December at the drive-in Saturday night. There's no need for disorderly conduct.
Now, I'm the judge.
Or is there?
And you'll play by my rules.
Can Beau Bridges and Julianne Phillips beat the clock? In 7 hours to judgment? Then the heat's still on.
What heat?
A dead girl on the beach that creates heat.
It's a sticky situation for call girl Catherine and Detective Reynolds in Hustle. But really, home is where the heart is.
We're family now.
Unless, of course, it happens to be at grandmother's house. Then it's off to the cabin we go for your average American family. But this trip to the mountains amounts to nothing but fear. Fear not, for Action Jackson is on the way.
I have to catch a cab.
And to the rescue.
Better believe it, bro.
Seeing is believing at the drive-in Saturday night in December on Cinemax.
Don't go away. The late, late, late night movie will be right back.
At Cinemax, we've got the film and nothing but the film. No commercials, no cuts. Just all the great stuff that makes a classic, Cinemax. More movies, more choice, more classics. Choice. Next, Audrey Hepburn's a feisty flower girl and Rex Harrison's growing accustomed to her face in My Fair Lady. This month's classic collection thanks heaven for little girls. Next.
Joy!
There's a lot of joy coming your way this holiday season, and December on Cinemax is no exception.
The cooking, the pampering, the dressing.
He's a prince who's coming of age.
Now you're a man who's about to be married.
And going on a little journey.
I want a woman that's going to arouse my intellect as well as my loins.
Where will you find such a woman?
In America.
Fascinating. Eddie Murphy and Arsenio Hall are going for broke and coming to America. In December, you won't know if you're coming or going from all the laughter.
He's drunk.
Smile.
What?
He didn't smile.
But will with Cinemax Cinemania, we got the beat on comedy.
Float like a butterfly and sting like a bee.
The humans are very curious to us.
They have landed and are among us.
Why can't they go to Russia or someplace like that?
And James Caan may just be fighting a losing battle.
My true name is Stanja Sorensa.
Sorensa, well, gesundheit. I'll call you George.
Alien Nation. It's only part of an all-points lookout.
Help! Help! They're coming!
Are they human?
It was something, but it was not human.
Or is it an alien invasion?
Spooky.
Beau Bridges is up against it, and the action's revved up to full throttle at the drive-in Saturday night. It's a wild 7 hours to judgment.
Wild is the word.
She entered our lives as a child and has remained a star for 5 decades.
I don't believe it.
In December, Cinemax pays tribute to one of the most glamorous, most provocative actresses of all time.
Oh, that's wonderful.
6 films starring Elizabeth Taylor.
Why don't we go on a long trip?
Among December's Cinemax Classic Collection, we'll take you to the magnificent world of T.E. Lawrence. Peter O'Toole is Lawrence of Arabia. Then,
Courage and inspiration emanate from the heart.
Are you an addict, girl?
As Michael Keaton fights to be clean and sober, while Edward James Olmos is an outstanding teacher who must stand and deliver. And if you're looking for a guy who delivers, Friday After Dark's got a man for sale. Coming later in December, Crazy About the Movies, William Holden, the Golden Boy, and a decade of fabulous films with the greatest hits of the 80s. But in the meantime, there's no stopping Alien Nation on December 3rd. Oh. And there's no stopping the laughs on December 8th because Eddie Murphy's coming to America. Cinemax in December. More movies, more choice, and more joy to brighten your holiday season.
Audrey Hepburn has always been a bit like royalty. She was the princess to Hollywood's leading princes. Her regal looks and stylish elegance made her a fashion icon when blonde bombshells were the rage. And her discovery by director William Wyler, who cast her opposite Gregory Peck in Roman Holiday, is truly a fairy tale story.
I've never been alone with a man before, even with my dress on. With my dress off, it's most unusual. I don't seem to mind. Do you?
I was a dancer in London when he was looking for an unknown face to do his Roman Holiday, and I couldn't have been more unknown. And he tested me, had me tested along with lots of other girls, and thanks to him, I won the part, and also thanks to Greg, because Greg quite clearly had co-partner approval. Greg was this big, famous, you know, strong, romantic star that I'd seen in pictures, and I was quite apprehensive about meeting him, and I thought he would probably be just that way, you know, and he was. So the two of them launched me on a career which has really brought me nothing but happiness.
And while Hepburn's fond memories of Roman Holiday may bring a tear to her eye, she recalls needing a little help during her first big crying scene.
But this was sort of at the end of the picture, and we were all rather tired, and I'm supposed to say goodbye to Greg, and we're sitting in the car, and this is our last scene, and the last time we'll see each other. And I just, you know, I wasn't at all experienced, and I couldn't bring up the somehow I felt the scene, but couldn't cry. And Willie, who'd always been so dear and so adorable with me, suddenly got so cross and blew his top at me, and I burst into tears, and they shut the scene, and that was that.
Hepburn won the Academy Award for that performance and followed it up with a string of successes, becoming, along with Elizabeth Taylor, the highest-paid female star of her era. She worked with the screen's most sought-after directors.
You can go down the list. I mean, I did 3 pictures with William Wyler. No wonder I talk about him a lot. And I did 2 with Billy Wilder. And I worked with Fred Zinnemann and Stanley Donen and Blake Edwards and, I mean, you name it. Let's not even talk about Cary Grant and Gary Cooper and Humphrey Bogart.
Hepburn played opposite Bogart in Sabrina, Cooper in Love in the Afternoon, and Grant in Charade. But Funny Face allowed her to fulfill a dream she had as a young ballerina, to dance with a stare.
Well, he was unique, you know. And I've said this before, but it really was an extraordinary experience, because it is every woman's dream to dance with Fred Astaire, to have once done it, and I did.
But perhaps Hepburn's most memorable role was that of Holly Golightly, the ultimate princess, in the 60s classic Breakfast at Tiffany's.
Tell you one thing, Fred, darling. I'd marry you for your money in a minute. Would you marry me for my money?
In a minute.
So I guess it's pretty lucky neither of us is rich, huh?
It's the one picture I'm able to look at without somehow finding fault with myself. Isn't that funny? I mean, I'm very critical. And I can quite enjoy looking at Breakfast at Tiffany's. I love that movie.
Breakfast at Tiffany's also epitomizes the Audrey Hepburn look. Her spidery bangs, waif-like figure, and stylish clothes made her one of the biggest fashion influences of her time. For this, she credits her collaboration with Paris designer Hubert Givenchy.
I didn't put on anything. I've always worn Givenchy. That's not anything. I was responsible for a lot of Japanese girls cutting their hair, and I got blamed for it.
Today, Hepburn is more queen than princess. Her experiences in Africa as a special ambassador for UNICEF have left as much, if not more, of an impression on the legendary actress than her brilliant screen career.
People adored me. People and their children. This is, I mean, I knew I would see suffering. I knew I would see the results of the drought and so forth. I was not prepared for the extraordinary quality and beauty of the people. They are really very extraordinary. They have great dignity and enormous patience, great beauty. And the way they more or less accept their state rather than their fate, if you like, is marvelous.
Movie fans do miss Audrey, but does she miss the excitement of Hollywood?
I don't miss it because I still feel involved. You know, I mean, I withdrew from pictures. Curiously enough, I withdrew from pictures when my eldest son started to go to school. And so I more or less stayed home since then, except for a few pictures. Now I'm going around the world for children.
More movies, more choice. Next, Audrey Hepburn's a feisty flower girl and Rex Harrison's growing accustomed to her face in My Fair Lady. This month's classic collection thanks heaven for little girls. Next.
In December, the best of Hollywood comes to Cinemax when William Wyler takes the director's chair.
Don't tell me not to live, just sit and putter. Like candy and the sun's a ball of butter. Don't bring around a cloud to rain on my parade.
Talent and guts made her a showstopper. Barbara Streisand is Fanny Bryce, funny girl.
It's me and not you who told you you're allowed to rain on my parade.
Then...
Mr. Bradley, I have a confession to make.
Confession?
We can't go running around town with a hot princess.
Audrey Hepburn and Gregory Peck take a Roman holiday.
You're getting too superior, McCloud, a one-man army against crime.
Kirk Douglas takes vengeance to heart in Detective Story.
I'm not running anymore.
And Lee J. Cobb takes on Southern bigotry in The Liberation of L.B. Jones. Four star-studded films with a common thread. William Wyler in the director's chair. December on Cinemax.
She's a matchless beauty, vulnerable and fierce, innocent and seductive. And in December, Cinemax presents six films, all starring Elizabeth Taylor, beginning with the 1944 classic that made her a star.
I'll not let you ride, Bob, but I won't let you do it.
But he'll be an enchanted horse with invisible wings to take him over every jump if I ride him.
Mickey Rooney co-stars in National Velvet.
I love you. And I must not feel it.
Romance and intrigue became her trademarks, as in the 1952 epic, Ivanhoe. Then, once again, she beat the odds to win love in Elephant Walk.
I feel all the time like a cat on a hot tin roof.
In this unforgettable performance, Taylor lights up the screen with Paul Newman in Cat on a Hot Tin Roof. She won the 1960 Academy Award for the torrid Butterfield 8. And we get a peek at another side of the actress when the legendary team of Taylor and Burton ignite Shakespeare's boisterous tale, The Taming of the Shrew. In December, Cinemax presents an alluring retrospective starring Elizabeth Taylor.
The following movie is rated G.